Hello students, this is Vasant Naik from Vastech channel. So we will continue our module 2 session. In this session we will see the interrupt in 8086 PC. So interrupt in 8086 PC. So what is interrupt? A interrupt is an external event that informs the CPU that a device needs a service. It is an external event that informs the CPU that a device needs its service. Whose service? Suppose I have connected keyboard to the CPU. I have connected mouse to the CPU. When you type on the keyboard, when you click the mouse, it is an interrupt to the CPU. That tells the CPU that it needs service of the CPU. So in 8086, there are 256 interrupts. When an interrupt is executed, what microprocessor will do? Microprocessor will alt the present execution and it will execute the interrupt service related program. That is called as interrupt service routine. But before executing that routine, it will automatically save the flag register, instruction pointer, code segment register on the stack, because once it completes the interrupt service routine, it will return to the original location. From there, it has to continue its routine flow. For that, it has to save all these register in the stack. Then it goes to the interrupt service routine, which is a fixed memory location. So now, it is a fixed memory location. That fixed memory location is 4 times the value of the interrupt number. For example, as I said, there are 256 interrupts. Here you can see this interrupts are in hexadecimal format 0 to FF. So when the interrupt is called, then the physical address and logical address is given here. For the first interrupt, the physical address is 4 times the first interrupts. For the second interrupt, the physical address is 4 times the second interrupt. Third interrupt, physical address is multiplied by 3 of the interrupt number. So when the particular interrupt is called, the program goes to the particular location, which is 4 times of the interrupt number. For example, when the interrupt 3 is called, it goes to the location 000C. Or when the interrupt 5 is called, it goes to the location 0014. Now, what is there in that location? In that location, the value of the instruction pointer and code segment register, the value of the code segment register is stored. Means, the address of the interrupt service routine is stored in this table. So now I can say this table is a IVT table. What is that IVT table? Interrupt vector table. Interrupt vector table contains the address of the various interrupt service routine. Now what is interrupt service routine? Interrupt service routine is a program. Particular program associated with the particular interrupt, and it is stored in the particular location. That address of that interrupt service routine is stored in interrupt vector table. So interrupt vector table is in interrupt vector table. You can see on the this one slide. This is the interrupt vector table. So for the particular interrupt, that vector table address is multiplied by फोर So now you see interrupt service routine. Every interrupt, there is a program associated with it. And that program is called as interrupt service routine or interrupt handler. So this program is called when the interrupt is invoked. So when the interrupt is invoked, this program is executed. So now how it will be executed, we will see. Before that, find the physical address and logical address in the interrupt vector table. For example, interrupt 12H. Interrupt 12H, what you have to do is, you have to multiply by 4. That time it gives 48H. From this address, 4 bytes. 48H to 49, 4A, 4BH. In this address, this address of the service routine is stored. Please remember this one. For example, INT 8, here H is not given because you have to remember till 0 to 9, whether it is hexadecimal system or decimal system, if you don't write H, it's okay. But after 9, you have to write H, otherwise it will treat it as a decimal. So here 8, multiply this 8 by 4, 32. Now you have to convert this into hexadecimal, 20H. This is the location, 20. 21, 22, 23, 4 bytes. In this location, the value of the interrupt service routine is stored. Please remember. So now, followed by, how processing of the interrupt works? Very, very important question. See, for example, this is the, this one, slide. When the main line, in the year, you can see main line program, the program is executing. And suddenly there is an interrupt. At that time, our processor will halt the main program, and what it will do? It will push the flag register into the stack. It will clear the interrupt flag. As soon as the interrupt comes, it will clear that interrupt flag. It will clear the trap flag. It will push the content of the current segment, code segment and instruction pointer at this point to which one? Stack, then it will fetch the ISR address and it will jump to the ISR address. There it will push the registers to the stack, whatever required, and it will execute the ISR service routine. And while returning, before executing the IRETURN instruction in that procedure, it will pop the registers and it will pop IP and CS, and it will return to the original point of execution, and from there it will continue. This is called as processing interrupts. A very, very important question. How the interrupt is processed? You have to write the diagram. Along with that, 6 to 7 points are given in the notes and textbook that you have to write. How it works? Now, next one is, what is the difference between call instruction and int instruction? That is very important. So, difference between call instruction. So, call instruction used by normally by the programmer. When you use the call instruction, then instruction can jump to any location in that particular 1 MB range. But int instruction, int with number, goes to fixed memory location. Please remember this one. Call for instruction used by the programmer in the sequence of instruction in the program. So call instruction is used by the programmer. But int instruction is not used by the programmer. Int is externally activated either through hardware interrupt, by means of hardware interrupt. Now, call instruction cannot be masked, that means cannot be disabled. But int instruction, external interrupt can be masked. We have for that different procedure to mask that one. So now, call for instruction automatically saves this one, code segment register and instruction pointer when it jumps to the next instruction, to the stack. But our int instruction saves all this information along with the flag register also. It saves the flag register. It needs the flag register content also when once it returns. At the end, last fifth point is at the end of the this one call subroutine. Call subroutine, there is an instruction called as return for. This is the last instruction when you use the call. That instruction will be executed and it will pop up. Which will pop the this one code segment and instruction pointer. Here it is not like that. Here it is I written instruction, this will pop up the flag register and code segment and IP. So this is one important difference between 5 marks question. What is the difference between call instruction and int instruction? So this is the difference. You have to understand this is the difference and you have to write this one. Try to understand this one.